Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Ant Legion for the Swarm on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Ant Legion for the Swarm and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Ant Legion for the Swarm. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all mates, the first thing to do is to launch our main browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's go to this URL that I have highlighted in green color. Now, you can see on the screen. There is no need to type anything, because there's the link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed on this page on our website of Usitility, at which we have a nice detailed demonstration on how to download Ant Legion for the Swarm on laptop or computer. We scroll down a bit and press on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we land here on the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to enjoy the game Ant Legion for the Swarm on the PC. As you can see here, we get a great deal of advantages of preferring that emulator. Now we are on the way to proceed to download the Ant Legion for the Swarm by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. Next step is clicking on it. And the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, here is located the download. It's a file to execute. What we are going to do is to launch the executable file, okay, then we need to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the laptop or device. We answered yes. I minimize the web browser to view the installer significantly better. The installer is pretty simple. It consists of two choices, install, and setup path. I am going to make it clear what setup path genuinely does. We merely click on it. So we discover that we get here the path where your emulator is going to be put in. If we want to change this directory we have got to click on this browse button, and therefore we opt for another folder and install the emulator specifically where we would like. I will keep it by default. I simply click on back. So I pick install. Voila! The install commences and it will proceed in the download of those megabytes that happens to be displayed on that computer screen. After you download it, it could possibly be more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed could go at a higher speed or slower, subject to your type of access to the web and according to the efficiency of the emulator hosting servers. Immediately they are going really fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this moment, the emulator has actually been launched automatically. As you can observe, down here, there is a progress bar which will move forward to the right and when it comes to the ending, the emulator will be launched for the very first time. The fact is the emulator was already launched here for the first time. Before we carry on, as you can observe, it has created two software icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi Instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is the one we're focused on. When we choose to launch Ant Legion for the Swarm on our laptop or computer, we double-click that icon and consequently use the emulator. The BlueStacks Multi Instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Why don't we perform the next step, which is actually a requirement, and that is to visit the Google Play Store. And we will simply click on Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is presented. In this case we need to sign in. At this time as soon as we are on this page, we have to execute the next phase that is definitely mandatory. Therefore we mouse click on Sign In. At this moment it announces checking info. It may sometimes get blocked in checking info and so it does not continue. If that's the case, you could try to connect to your account after a couple of hours it's going to probably be sorted out. At this moment we shall type in our email and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email and its related password. For instance you could use the exact same email address you're using at the moment in your YouTube account. Then I am going to provide my details and I will revisit after I have accomplished it. That's it, details entered. Below is Google welcoming us and supplying us the terms of service. We will consent to all of them simply by pressing, I agree. Following, it allow us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can let it selected and it will create a backup of your files on this device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you do what you want. We click on accept. Google Play Store is launched by default and on autopilot. To set up the game, we would need to go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking that icon designated green colored. Right now that we are watching the desktop of the Android emulator, we notice that we have there the install game button. We simply click on that button. There we access to the video game. So let's simply click right here on the install button that I'm displaying now in green color. And this will initiate the setup. At this moment it is going to install the game, it might take some time or perhaps it might well be extremely fast. That all is determined on our internet access. It has as of now completed installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on the following button that I am emphasizing in green, so that you can launch Ant Legion for the Swarm for the very first time. We're presently on the emulator desktop, then we're going to mouse click on that fresh Ant Legion for the Swarm icon that has been created. This video game is launched for the first time. Now there we end up with it, I can mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should talk about the sound level of the emulator. It is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume, this way we won't use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of this emulator. And to appreciate the experience to the max, we can switch on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This is simply the very first one, we just click on this software icon which I'm pointing out in green. And the display screen is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. Assuming that we really want to enjoy the application using all the screen, we click this icon. And then we would probably without a doubt be enjoying the game in 100% screen setting. To stop the full screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we'd currently be in normal display screen setting. At present, I am ready to reveal you the keyboard mapping that is really very useful. This means we will likely be in a position to utilize the game app a lot more easily. The first thing is to mouse click this application icon. And here you will be able to make the recommended configuration settings. I am going to leave the default settings, however if you like to adjust this, you can easily achieve it without having problem. Obviously, the emulator is absolutely in our language. Sometimes it occurs that your emulator is presented in the wrong language, for example, in Chinese language. And therefore to set it up in the correct language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then right here throughout additional settings, we mouse click on the language drop down. We can easily choose the language we want, Spanish, Japanese, and so on. When the language is decided, we could save, the emulator would restart, and also the Android game, the next time we start it, will of course be in the preferred language. At present, there's another detail that we have to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive an email saying that a brand new electronic device has been associated with our Google account. It is going to check with us if we're the ones who have connected that electronic device. Absolutely, we shouldn't get worried, simply because the emulator is acting as an Android device. In order to identify which electronic device is being emulated, we go right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. Therefore we go here to the model option. And now we notice that the emulator is emulating a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for the video user demo. I anticipate you appreciated it, especially that you found it informative. In that case, offer it a nice thumb up, subscribe to the channel, and any remarks, requests or suggestions, let them in the comment area down below. You can even comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams from time to time, you have it below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Simply click on any of these instructional videos that are appearing on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the following instructional videos. Bye!